got Shalom. I'm back with another one, and as you can see by the image, you know where I'm going. So I'm gonna touch into Ruddy in depth. All right, so after this, it's gonna be a little tedious and long possibly, but after this, disclaimer, if you come on here and like you don't address anything I brought out, or you bringing up stuff that I already addressed, I'm either blocking you or you getting no response. All right, so I'm done with you scoffers, all right, and your false information and falsehood. All right, so we're going to deal with this Ruddy thing, and it's going to be to the T of understanding, by the power and the spirit of the Most High through his son. All right, so let's get it. All right, but firstly, so we see this here is an image of King David, okay, which can be found in Italy. All right, and as you can see, it's clearly a black man. All right, light skin, ruddy. Okay, which black people have that can have a red tint on them, reddish brown, which I'm gonna deal with all of that. All right, so let's continue. Just wanted to show some more images. Okay, so some of these catacombs, Russian icons during the Dark Ages. Okay, so just wanted to show this. So the term ruddy can be found only five times. Okay, only five times. Again, with David, Solomon, and then again, which it's figurative, but Lamentations, and you also have Esther. Okay, so I just wanted to show this, that it's only used five times. Okay, so let's get the understanding. Okay, so this is the Compact Bible Dictionary. A word used to refer to a red or fair complexion, again, which that red is not the same like Edom, okay, red or Esau. Okay, and the fair, again, when we look at the Hebrew, fair is talking about beautiful. That's why a lot of these translations talk about a beautiful count. They were ready with a beautiful countenance or appearance. Okay, so the point is, in contrast to the dark skin of the Hebrews, right there we can close the book. Right there we can close the book, be done. Because showing you from Wesley Snipes to someone light skinned, again, like I said, we've been called red bone before, but let's get some more. I'm gonna go all into it. So I wanted to bring this out to get a point. Okay, so we know that Ham is the progenitor of the dark races, not the Negroes. Okay, so if we didn't come from Ham, again, coming from Shem, but I wanted to bring that out just to back up what I always keep bringing out in the Talmud. All right. Okay, again, Shem was dark, Ham was dark. Alright, so part two coming. Alright, so I wanted to start with the Great Bible. Okay, 1539, okay, before the King James. Let's see what it says about David. Let's go to 1 Samuel 16. Okay, so getting to the point, and he was brown and of an excellent beauty. Okay, so in the 1500s, they already knew this. Okay, again, like I said, a lot of words have been changed from their original meaning. But let's go to chapter 17 now. Okay, so 17 and 42. So, and well-colored. Okay, and goodly to look upon. Okay, so that's what they knew ready as. Okay, we just got it brown and well-colored. Who was called colored? Okay. All right, so we know that color basically describing black people, African Americans. And I use black loosely because that's another thing. A lot of people have this misconception that they're brown. People thinking they're brown when they're not. They're tan or beige. And then they're calling us black. We're not black. Okay, we're all different shades of brown. It's clear. And I just got to show us a chart so people, so simple. Like, you know what I'm saying? No one is black. Okay, no one is white. All right, no one is yellow. You know what I'm saying? Again, these are just descriptive terms. But again, I'm going to show that all these so-called terms, red and all, they can have brown. You can have a yellow brownish tint. You can have a reddish brownish tint. All right, let's get it. Okay, I just wanted to show some more. So let's get some other translations. So New International Version told you it could be a healthy complexion. He was glowing with health and a fine appearance and handsome features. Let's look at the New Living Translation. He was dark and handsome. Okay, so that they, how come they know that it was dark? Okay, we just read, that's why I went to the 1500s. okay, to smash all of that. They knew he was brown, okay, or he was brown, reddish brown. Okay, let's continue. Okay, again, healthy complexion. Now we see the international standard version. He had a dark and healthy complexion. Dark, healthy complexion with beautiful eyes, and he was handsome. All right, so that's just cutting you. Now, the New Heart English Bible, and he was reddish brown. Okay, so let's get some, visuals, all right? Okay, so looking at the definition, reddish brown, a shade of brown with a tinge of red, okay? So that's a small tinge, all right? But look at sienna and mahogany. Okay, so the woman in the middle, sienna, deep red hue. Even dark sienna, dark reddish brown. All right, so I'll be back with part three. All right, so part three. And when you look up that dark in the Hebrew, it's still going to show ruddy and still trip people up. It's not like they're going to change it to the correct word for dark, okay? But now let's touch into Solomon, okay? So this is the 16th century depiction of dark-skinned King Solomon, okay? And we know that, again, a lot of whitewashing took place during the Renaissance. And even you got the popes and things like, you got the popes and bowing down to it and stuff like that. Okay, so just to show, basically, like during the Dark Ages, again, that the whitewashing that took place, and yeah, now everyone's confused. And even like here, people are confused thinking that white in this verse is talking about white people or white skin. Again, look at the examples, dazzling, radiant, okay? But then we see ruddy. Okay, and right here, New Living Translation, again, dark and dazzling. Okay, my beloved is dazzling with a dark and healthy complexion. Again, told you it was a healthy complexion also. But notice here, it says, my beloved is clear and ruddy. Let's get some. Okay, and that's why I said a lot of y'all just overlook everything. Y'all don't even go in depth. You just read one thing and then you run off with it. Okay, like somebody will read this, okay, look at, oh, to blush in the red, okay, but did you notice the dark skinned Hebrews found great beauty and a clear complexion? Okay, so even like that, it's kind of like, even if you want to go to Song Solomon, the first chapter, it sounds like some type of colorism going on, which happens in the black community. Yeah, light skin versus dark skin. Oh, everyone is trying to be mixed, so on and so forth. Okay, but you notice here again, the contrast to the dark skin of the Hebrews, we brought that out. So that's the cut. Okay, so you can't get around that. And even when we're talking about Lamentations, again, that's all figurative, all right? But even then, you go to Lamentations 5, as you can see at the top, and you read down to grow hot and to become more warm, because even, again, when black people, have famine, you know, it's a famine, we become darker, all right? But even noticing how it says hot, you know what I'm saying? Even that word black can be translated as hot. Who else was called hot or considered hot? All right, so Ham. Okay, Israelites were compared to them. All right, so we was always compared to them. Okay, African nation. Okay, like I always be bringing out, the Romans said that the Jews were the color of the Ethiopians. Okay, again, Tacitus. Okay, many assure us that the Jews are descended from those Ethiopians. Okay, so it's clear. Okay, the Josephus confirmed. So let's touch into the Josephus about David. All right, so part four. So this is the antiquity of the Jews. All right, but it's saying, now as soon as his father had sent for David and he was come, he appeared to be of a yellow complexion. Okay, so people probably would lose their minds with the term yellow or what it might mean today in this society. But we're going to deal with all of that and get the full understanding. Okay, so, and you know, there, and I've seen different translations from the Josephus, and the yellow is taken out. So again, that's again messing with history and trying to flip and change. But again, that's why I dealt with all them Bible verses, so no one can get confused. Okay, so let's get some understanding of the word tawny. Okay, so it says tan colored. Okay, but we see like the brownish yellow of tan leather, dark brown tan. All right. Okay, and I'm not going to show you a whole bunch of leather belts or, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to show you the complexions of what tawny could be, or, you know, the shades of tawny, okay? But it says light brown to brownish orange color. The synonym, swarthy, we know that means dark, okay? So, again, like I said, from a tawny light skin complexion down to a dark brown, you know, complexion. And in between that, you have reddish brown, so on and so forth. Now, this is from Benjamin Franklin. You can look this up. This is what he was saying about the different continents. Now, he said, all Africa is black or tawny. Okay, so that's what I wanted to get right there. And then, as you, I mean, you can see America, holy soul. So, again, so for y'all that, oh, yeah, y'all only came through slave ships, you know, Negroes been in America. All right, but that's another topic. All right. Okay, so earlier we got the sienna color, which was dark yellowish brown. I wanted to touch into caramel because that's, again, we calling ourselves caramel, pecan, and all of this stuff. So golden light browns with soft complexions. Okay, now look at this. What ethnicity is caramel skin? Okay, the caramel complexion is rich in a range of greenish yellow, golden, and red undertones. Okay, and notice it says the complexion can be a deep tan of chocolate brown or a lighter shade. It is well suited for black women, okay, from diverse backgrounds. Okay, so I mean, when you look up caramel, it's always showing a black woman. Okay, so, and that's a tawny light complexion. Okay, yeah, so to give more visuals, noticing this is brown sugar. You have the light brown sugar and the dark brown sugar. Okay, so in this chart, you can see tawny, you can see caramel. Okay, again, on the left side, you see tawny right next to caramel. All right, so I'm back, part five. So I was touching into tawny and showing how, you know, it called, Josephus called David yellow. Okay, but just showing how the other versions called him dark brown. All of these can go with black people. So that the point is ruddy can mean all of these things. All right, so as you see, Steph Curry, right here, this is that complexion, you know, that reddish tint on him. But let me show some more. Okay, so, and you got a lot of outlandish claims, you know what I'm saying? Like, black people can't have red hair, or like we can't blush, or, you know, stuff like that. But I've been showing that the red, or the brownish red, reddish brown is applying to us. Okay, so, and I got more, so y'all hold on tight, because I got some other gems about to bring them out in a minute. But, you know, just, again, the visuals just showing you. Now, I'm doing this because you got dumb comments like this. Okay, stupid comments like this, you know what I'm saying, is why I do this, you know what I'm saying? I already been showing what ready means, and it's different from the red that specified we eat them. But even then, like I said, ruddy is reddish brown, tawny, light complexion. It could be healthy complexion. I've been showing that, and I got more fire coming up. All right, but dumb comments like this, this is why I do this. So you guys, scoffers, whether it's Jew or Gentile, coming on here, talk, oh, why are you bringing up race? Mainly it's you Gentiles that's coming on here talking. But again, you don't tell Hollywood to stop making these whitewashed movies. You know what I'm saying? But as soon as we try to bring out the truth, now it's a problem. All right, but I'm gonna bring out this truth. Okay, so a lot of this I'm finding on Google Images, but you can see even tawny, as you see the complexion of tawny. Okay, bronze skin tone. As you can see, it says red undertone. So again, I'm just bringing visuals. So I just wanted to bring this out. I don't think I did, but just to show what brown really means, because, you know, I'm tired of people think, oh, yeah, we're black. And then, and I talked about this earlier, but just wanted to show. So for the people that's acting like, yeah, we're brown and you're black, and they weren't black, they were brown, and all, you know what I'm saying? This is the real definition of what it means to be brown. Okay, so this is from an article called Jewish Blackness, and I wanted to talk about Robert Knox and Cinder Gilman, but it says, though not actually black, the purest of the Jewish race is a dark, tawny, yellow color person. Okay, so this is from a book called Hybrid Hate by Tuto Parfit, and just an overview, he was talking about how Gilman and Knox were basically saying that the Jews were Negroid, okay? Be back with part six. Okay, so part six. So when I went on Google, and every time I've been looking for, like, the different skin tones, all the ones that I'm saying that the Jews were and applies to ready they show for the black women. All right, so tawny, okay, we show like chestnut, you know, caramel, all of these can represent a ruddy, darkest brown or dark reddish brown tint or light reddish brown tint. All right. Okay, so this is from the book Ancient and Modern Britons, but I'm going to skip to page 377, but read this. Okay, so right here, Roa, or as we now pronounce it in English, ruddy and red signifies both black or tawny, and red or ruddy in the Western Highlands. Okay, so also that Deirdre, which is understood to mean red in Gaelic, has become dark. Okay, so this is what these words originally meant and was used for, all right? Okay, so let's delve a little bit more into that word Raoud or Roa. So we said red, redheaded, okay? And I just showed, that's why I showed that first, so scoffers, y'all can't say nothing. But look at where it says usage notes, dark brownish red, so we can't get it twisted. But let's get some more. Okay, so it says meaning a red, specifically russet, or copper color. So keep copper color in mind, but let's look at what russet means. So bam. Okay, so russet is a reddish brown in color. Okay, the adjective. So I ain't gotta go in grammar, you know, teach y'all grammar. Y'all know what it is. Okay, so russet is a reddish brown color. That's what ruddy is. Okay, I've been showing y'all and showing y'all what brown was. Dark, or meaning dark. Okay, so let's get some more though. So I said, keep copper color in mind. Okay, so I wanted to bring this out from the Webster's about American, because, you know, applied to Aboriginals or copper color races, because you got these people that, oh, y'all trying to be culture vultures or wobbles or we was kings, you know, because I subscribe to, you know, knowing that Negroes have been in America prior to the slave trade. Okay, but they were calling them copper color. Okay, and Aboriginals, which we know even Malcolm X told y'all that Aboriginals, y'all don't want to be Aboriginals because Aboriginals is black people, all right? But even the term in, you know, in that we was called was applied to Indians as well, but that's another topic. Because I wanted to prove all things. So as you see, Indians was called the N, and it says Aborigine. I just don't want to get flagged. Okay, so copper color, reddish brown color. All right, so brown sienna, reddish brown mahogany, we brought that out earlier, so showing you what copper color can stand for. Be back. Okay, so I told y'all it was going to be a long one, because after this, I'm pretty much done. I ain't going to be talking about ready no more, you know what I'm saying? But we talked about copper color, how it was reddish brown, okay, that's ready for y'all. But as you can notice here on these slave ads, a Negro man of dark copper color, this one Bob, copper color, high cheekbones. Okay, got some more. So Thomas, Negro boy, it says, yeah, copper color. Cynthia, a Negro girl about 9 or 10 years of age, of a copper color. Come on. Okay, so my Negro woman Jane, okay, getting to the point, high of dark copper color. Okay, reddish brown, remember. Okay, ready. This one was kind of hard to read, but I believe his name was Daniel. And as you can see, it says dark copper color. All right, so this magazine back then was basically the Ebony and the Jet magazine of that time. Okay, and notice again, copper. So, I mean, I don't know what y'all gonna say, but I already showed what copper meant. And it's not a coincidence. They were the copper color races. All right, and this sister had red hair. So, I mean, what y'all gonna say then? Okay, so lastly, I want to bring out this from John Mackey. Now, he was talking about the different kings of England during the Dark Ages. Yes, the black people were the King James. All of them were black. And, I mean, I'm about to show an example, actually, two. Okay, so John Hollis, Duke of Newcastle. He was a black, ruddy-complexioned man. Okay, so from Wikisource, the same thing, black, ruddy-complexioned man. From John Mackey memoirs. But you're going to see this image. So that's what I'm saying. You got to put two and two together. You got to break the lies. Okay, so King Charles II, he was called the Black Boy of England. Okay, so I don't know what to tell y'all. OK, Okay, the facts and the truth is out there. You just got to find it. But it says Charles was a large, dark, and healthy baby. But you're going to look at it on Google search, Wikipedia, and it's going to be a whitewash image. All right, so I'm going to close it out with this. So this whole series been showing you that ready lost its original meaning. And just like I have on the screen, brunette, okay, darkened complexion, brownish, brown hair, dark complexion. All right, so, you know, but when you look in society of what a brunette is, okay, you're not going to see what we're seeing right here. So it's got to get your mind thinking. So we know that things have been changed. So same thing with the whole Adam topic when I brought out with Adam and this, you know, so y'all got to, you know, stay on the radar. All right, so with that, Shalom.